right. Completely I got distracted by the skins.
The skins. The skins. They're always doing this, the skins. But I mean, one thing that we're going to see here is it's basically the Slavic countries against Scandinavia at the moment. It's Ukraine versus Norway. So if Expert Gaming wants to continue the representation of this great country, Norway, they're going to have to win. And if NaVi want to continue the representation of Ukraine, well, there's Hellraisers there anyway. They can continue
close
that.
The close-up on the Orion skin.
That's a face-it skin, isn't it?
I think so, yeah.
It is.
I want it. I want this one.
If you have one, send it to DDK. At follow DDK. He'd love it. Send him a picture, actually, not the actual skin. Oh. I don't want you to send him the skin. That's not fair. Well, you can ask Seize. You can send him a message. Now, mate, can I have your Orion your skin, please? Set. Can I have your skin?
I don't think you'd be quite so accommodating.
He'd be like, no, go away, noob.
However, if this is the map that we are to see, we obviously already cracked the gaming map, which is quite cool because we actually have something to expect from not only their offense but also their defense. But we did get a glimpse of that.
Expert gaming, exactly. They're warmed up on this map, haven't they? They know how to kind of they've played this map just now against Lemon Dogs. They know what the weaknesses are and they know what their strengths are. So that's really good for them. NaVi, on the other hand, haven't had time to watch Expert Gaming play on Mirage just before, so they don't really know exactly which points they have to concentrate.
There's one big difference, I think, between NaVi and Delpan's lots, Aligon or now Lemon Dogs. I mean, even if they are going to be sticking together as a team, now, you know, Aligon or Lemon Dogs, they haven't been playing together for a long, long time. Not nearly as long as NaVi have been playing together. So we're going to be seeing top gameplay from a very, very top team that has stuck together for quite some time. They're going to have their strats in order. They're going to have good setups and good awareness of one another. And that chemistry is really going to work many times. So this is going to be a very different game for Expert Gaming. So I feel like Expert Gaming could actually get... I think this game could be very, very, very different. I think NaVi, if they're playing as NaVi, you would expect NaVi to play, I'm going to be anticipating quite a crushing scoreline from them. So we're going to have to wait and see how that actually works out.
It's going to be quite interesting, actually. I really don't know which direction it'll take. I mean, if NaVi can really, really solidify their lead as a CT side against the weaker Expert Gaming T side, then Expert Gaming are going to be in quite a bit of trouble.
Yeah.
However, if Expert Gaming can get quite a few rounds on the T side and do as well as they did against Lemon Dogs on the CT, well,
they want to start on CT, don't they? The Norwegians, really want to start on CT. It's actually kind of... I thought the game was going to start. I mean, it's going into knife round. They did knife round.
And then all of a sudden...
And I could have taken people on the magical journey of analysis through
DDK's magical journey.
But now I'm scared to do it because the game is supposed to start any second.
Yeah, but what kind of magic are you talking about?
I don't know.
Is it the kind of magic where you...
if I told you, then it wouldn't be magic, would it?
Do I need to ingest anything to take part in this magical journey, or is it just...
Nope. You just got to
watch. Oh, it's PG.
It is. Now, we're getting live with the pistol, so the timing has worked out wonderfully. NaVi against Expert Gaming, the Norwegian team. Can they do it here against this immense power? Let's see. And they're going to be pushing in onto the B bomb site. And so far, they're getting the frags they need. Those entries are coming. The damage is coming in. Stig. Oh, my goodness. This flank potential is going to be wondrous. Can he make it work? In there, defending from Forest, and things are going well here for the Norwegians. They're on the site, but the bomb is not down just yet. They might be able to
run around. Towards bomb site A, actually, if they wanted to. Oh, this is what's going on. The CTs have no idea. Oh, dear Lord. What is going on? C's got hit from behind as well. They really don't know what's going on here. Expert, it's a very nice rotation. They put themselves in the stronger position. The CTs had almost full control of the bomb site, but they were able to kind of slip through into kitchen towards bomb site A. The bomb is planted, and Expert have to be very careful that they don't give away the bombsite too easily here. Stig, behind enemy lines, will be able to take down Starix. And Guardian is the last man standing. He does get a shot on Stig. But I don't think it's very probable that he'll be able to win this one. He's got the P2000. It's 2-1. They have to actually peek at the same time. They can't make this mistake of making it a 1-on-1 situation. And they made it. But Spitty actually took down Guardian. And from a 3-on-1, Guardian almost... Yep. That round.
It spots me. You're like calling comms. 3-2-1 peak. You know, someone's got to do that because
together
it's really hard to time that. You need to call it really in that kind of spot. Because peeking from both sides with a pistol, it's going to go well. But either way, that's going to be a good round for Expert Gaming. I love the little runaround situation. Again, good on the fly calling, good reactions.
As you mentioned,
but What is this? Oh, that CZ action is hot right now from NaVi. And they're going to return with some kills here, but a lot of damage has been done. Oh, Zeus is going to get himself a gun in shadow. Not even any damage on Zeus. And they have pistol armor. What is happening?
Jumping scout shot there by Guardian. This was a very, very good call here by the NaVi side, who went for a full bite on the second round, got armor, got the CZs, and Expert Gaming, I don't think, really expected that. They tried to go in slowly into bombsite A, which is a huge mistake. They lost two men early on in the round, and that put them in a very poor situation. And Guardian and the rest of the crew were just cleaning up with that jumping scout shot. So it's one-on-one, and the T's are back to step one, or square one, with Anita. They're trying to take on Guardian here on mid with the pistol. He's actually put down on 6 HP, but Zeus pops out, gets himself a triple. And Edward's gonna clean up the Ukrainian operation. Is relatively successful here on mid as NaVi get an easy anti-eco, putting them 2-1.
It's a shame that Expert didn't get a bomb plant in that round. If they were able to get a bomb plant, they'd be able to go for a buy, and they'd be able to destabilize the economy of NaVi, even if they didn't win, but just by getting a lot of frags. And that would have had a lot of value. But now we're in a spot where Expert have to eco again, even though look how close it was not to eco. Yeah. And so this kind of sucks for Expert Gaming. Ooh, nice little aggressive push there from Edward. They are all over the shop, aren't they? These NaVi lot, they're just taking control of mid. And this is unfortunate for Expert. But if there's one thing that we've learned from Expert, is don't count them out on Mirage.
It's the T side, it's their weaker side.
Yep.
Maze gets himself two kills. Does a bit of damage, actually. Yakin's coming. Ooh. He actually gets a shot on Starix as well. A headshot as well. So that's not bad. Expert Gaming now, 2 rounds behind NaVi. But they are able to buy some guns. And guns is what you need to win yourself some rounds. And Expert Gaming, they have to be careful. They have to try something very different here. They were able to win the pistol round earlier on. And they have to keep the momentum going, or they have to... Oh my goodness, there's a fast push here by the CTs into Palace. Is Yakin able to defend himself against that? Very nice by the CTs. And this is the thing with NaVi. They're actually playing a very, very dynamic CT setup. You can have CTs all over the place. You have Guardian pushing short. He was at mid earlier. At window, sorry. Little boost there to get the headshot. Very good job by Spitty. Zeus coming in from window.
There's someone here.
Well, he's going to be surprised. He had his nade out at the wrong moment. It's 2-on-4. Interesting play here. It's really dynamic CS that we're seeing at the moment. Not really what you'd expect. Some weird kills here and there. Sees that shot, knows that there is something going on nearby. He's being forced to defend himself. Getting that kill on Spitty at connector. Seized. Now, pushing through. Good flash. He's got 2 HP. Will he get the kill? This would be pretty disastrous if he did, but Stig will get the better of him. Starix now with 5 HP, the last man standing, and the bomb hasn't been planted yet. Starix rushing through underground quickly to bombsite B. This is actually a good choice here by Starix.
I think Skippy might have heard him. That's the thing. Like, if Skippy hadn't been in behind...
He didn't. Skippy has no idea he's there. He's coming up from behind. He's going to be able to get Skippy.
Silence weapon too.
Oh, he's not going to kill him. What is he going to do? Oh, he turns around. Nice. He does get the kill, though. Now it's him against Stig. He's got 5 HP. Stiggy, Stiggy, Stiggy. Will he be able to finish off the job for Expert Gaming and make it 3-on-2? 3-2, sorry. Well, he knows exactly where he is, actually. Starix turns around, Stig. Good positioning by Stig. Perfect positioning.
The crazy thing about Starix there is that, because, of course, if the AWPer didn't turn around, then what he was trying to do is like find the other frag first, because that's a secured frag.
Exactly.
If he gets like a bit further towards the car and stays out of vision and kills the other guy with the silencer, there's no way the AWPer is going to kill him. There's just no way. He's just always getting that frag. That's so unfortunate.
In my opinion, I think he should have made it nice and fast, because he had an M4 silenced, right? That's not going to give away his position on the radar. If he kills him, then rushes through and then just jumps into the bombsite, he could take him by surprise. But sadly, it is a loss for NaVi. They do have a full buy, however. Seized the only person with the FAMAS and no headgear. He's seen better days. His wallet is relatively empty. And it looks like, again, it's a standard split here by the Expert side, seeing if they can get a pick earlier on in the game in one of the bomb sites. But NaVi are doing a good job, as they will be able to take down Yakin earlier on in this round. Skippy will also go down. Eddie here pushing down mid. Seems one CT on short. And he does take him down. Edward's down now. Will Stig finish the job though? On Guardian? Sadly not. There was a bit of a frantic spray down there by Stig, and probably should have just tried to go for that tap. He Zeus pushes in. Connector is on 5 HP. Oh, goodness me. Zeus will be taken out by... But Guardian's going to hop out. Caesar is going to hop out as well. And now it's all up to base. He's only got 10 HP. And it looked like Expert might have been able to equalize the score, at least for a while longer. But two terrorists died in quick unison. And base has a pretty tough job. And he got caught in the frame as well there. That jump not working out for him. NaVi win and secure a fourth round for themselves, putting them two rounds ahead of Expert Gaming and perhaps forcing Expert Gaming on another eco.
Yeah, not much for them to do at this point. They don't have to be too worried just yet, though. They're still facing the early moments of the first half. They know Guardian is rocking the AWP in mid. They're just going to... I don't know. It may even serve them to just chill a little bit, but, you know, talk to each other. And they are just going to do a very delayed B push. This could work quite well because of the defensive setup. They're not going to have any... The DTs will have no information until contact is made here. And let's see if we can get the position. There's Edward over there. Short, really good position for stop this rush. And Edward just popping off heads left and right. And it's an easy defense, but that's okay. I mean, it was expected. Expert Gaming just rocking some pistols. Fully eco for them. Now they're going for the buy. And this is... Oh, or are they? They're actually still pretty without money. Are they going to go for an eco?
No, they can go for a buy, really, but they are going to go for an eco, actually. They're going to wait for better days because they haven't been able to plant the bomb lately. The one thing that we know about Expert Gaming that we've kind of noticed is that they're very good at playing from behind.
Nade coming up. He's the only one with nades on the side. We're going to see the nade go
He's going to throw those support nades for the rest of his teammates. We're pushing in from Palace, actually.
Okay. So it's the CT's on a kind of for the boxes there, for the bomb boxes. He's rushed the farm.
Wow. This is relatively good pushes. They're able to take down Starix early on, but Zeus and Edward getting themselves two kills each will completely demolish this pusher. It's a very dry eco push. But as I was mentioning before, Expert Gaming do a very good job of coming back from pretty poor scores, as we saw against Lemon Dogs. 14-6 was it? Yeah. Or 14 to...
It was a huge difference.
So we can't discount them.
I like the smoke there, because the way the smoke was placed, they've only got one. So they've actually practiced that before. It's like, okay, we're in a situation where we can buy one smoke and flashes. We just have to rush the bomber into the smoke. Yep. That's the only job. Just get the money for the plant. And that's it. I like that. That's really nice by them.
Well, they went for the save so they could get the op on Skippy. And we'll see if Skippy will be able to get make the change that they paid for. Starix will come behind enemy lines here, getting a kill on stake. That's not very good for the T side, as the CTs now know exactly which direction they'll be going. Starix will be coming up from behind. They have to have a CT there to fight back, and Zeus will catch base off guard as he tried to throw that flash. Is the T going to be ready for him? Starix actually doing an excellent job, and Yakin had no idea. Now it's up to Skippy here on mid, is being attacked from two sides at the same time. They lose the bomb, but he's able to take down Starix. It's actually a 2-on-3, which is very interesting, because for a moment it looked that like the CT side were a lot stronger and that they got the first two picks, and Starix was able to come up from behind. But however, I think Starix may be a bit too aggressive, and he should have stayed back down, perhaps shouldn't have gone for that peak. Now they're pushing into bomb site A, but a quick rotation here by NaVi. Very good game sense by the Ukrainians, knowing that they're going to push their Guardian, missing two shots, in fact. Zeus will pick up the pace, however, as he takes down Skippy. It's all up to Spitty right now. It's 3-on-1. He's got 100 HP. On the other hand, the enemies do not. Oh, and he will get himself a quick double kill. Zeus and Guardian are both down. It's him against Seized. He's jumping all over the place, but Seized will get the better of him. Very nice job there to save the round for NaVi and make it a 7-on-2. Good play by Skippy, however.
Dude,
for a moment there.
Starix, man, just slow pushing by himself. That just destroyed the round for them. It's just, it's a... Two flank kills.
They almost salvaged it. Well, Skippy almost salvaged it.
And if you look at it too, like it's such a small risk for them to do stuff like that. Look how much money they have. It's such a small risk, and the return is so high. Either he finds no one, gives them loads of information, and they get better positions, or he gets some frags.
Yep.
It's a win-win for them.
That's true. And it's really the main thing is information, and it kind of works out as well for the kills. Interesting smoke there. That's going to defuse the Molotov, but they pretty much figured out that they're probably not going to be pushing bombsite B right now. I mean, anyone with a sane mind wouldn't do that, especially when they're out with a flash. Starix gets dinked. And there's just quite a lot of HP put down on 14. I think that was a Galil headshot coming in from T-Ramp. But yeah, we got a bit of a hard sack there by Skippy. Guardian getting the first kill of this round, taking down Spitty. Nice. Stig in a good position to take down that very aggressive Guardian. Two kills there for Stig. And this round looks like it might be going towards the Norwegian side, as they are two men ahead with control of the bomb site, and the CTs are not in the best positions. We have one CT at CT spawn, the other at short. Starix playing nice and deep, same with Seized. Waiting for Expert Gaming to make a mistake, and that's a mistake Stig made, leaving bomb site, going to mid, trying to see if he can get any information, but he was hiding behind that smoke, and that smoke disappeared, and Zeus was ready for him. Nice flash there by Zeus. Base will take down Starix. It's up to Zeus now. He's the... Sorry, it's Seized. He's calling him Zeus all the game. It's actually Seized. And Seize is now going to try and retake the bombsite coming in from CT spawn. It's 2-on-1, and Skibby doesn't have a lot of HP. Have to be very careful. Nice flash there. That's going to get anyone who's hiding behind the box. Who knows? Nope. Vinny's going to be there for just a moment longer, but he will not be able to take down Base, who finishes off the job for Expert Gaming, getting them the third round of the game. And the Norwegians are maybe back into it. Their economy isn't hurt so much. Skibby picks up that M4.
Yep.
But on the other hand, Na'Vi have been saving up a lot of money, and this is their last buy round. If they lose the next one, they're going to be forced onto an eco. And that's going to put Expert Gaming 7-5.
Big push coming in here. Very, very fast turning up the pace. And Expert, they're getting absolutely mauled. And so far, it's just one frag for them, and only two players left. One is barely alive. And it's just pretty. And the thing about the previous round where they managed to create a success was that was the first round they were able to punish Na'Vi taking liberties. Because Na'Vi have been kind of strutting around the map, taking too many liberties.
That's
They've been pushing too much. They've been too aggressive, generally speaking. And Expert Gaming have been playing a little bit too passively, and just not they're not taking advantage of it. That was the first round where we saw that. And I don't know if it was deliberate, but that's definitely something they need to look for more, because RP, they're getting cocky, I think.
It is indeed, and you saw that jump there by Guardian. He got
punished
pretty badly by Stig. The thing is, they have to be very careful. On the other hand, Expert can't be trying to go in for those dry, fast pushes into the bomb sites. It's not working. Na'Vi's aim is far too on point, and you can see Seize there with an easy quad kill as he completely demolishes that eco. And it's not because it's an eco. It's because Seize is very good with his M4, and all the Na'Vi players are very good with their M4s, including Guardian himself. So they have to be careful. They can't go for these reckless, fast pushes into the bomb site. They have to take it easy. They have to wait for Na'Vi to make a mistake. They have to get that early pick onto one of the players, either at mid, or either at bomb site A, or bomb site B, and they have to wait for that aggressive push that is going to come sooner or later. Na'Vi have Guardian pushing here.
They're not used to seeing Guardian from the spot. This is the first time Guardian's done the short push. They're expecting that smoke was to stop him peeking mid. And actually, he's here on short. This could go really, really well. Even Edward pushing in to CPL to replace Guardian's usual AWPing from there. This is dangerous for them. And he missed the shot. That
Guardian.
Looked on. That looked on. But nevertheless, Edward picking up the pieces so far this round. Base to take one frag. But the thing is that there's two players lost. See, they can handle one player being lost, but now there's just three of them left. The bomb is down. They've got to think, okay, with what we've seen this round, what play do we make? But they don't have much to work with in this case, and they're all spread out. They're taking A, and
how did
he make
that shot? I have no idea. That was through the wall as well. Goodness me. He looked like he pretty much got away from that orb shot, but Guardian, wow. He must have done it on purpose. He dragged it through and got him through the wall. I mean,
it was really nice.
That was very nice. That could have been a different story indeed if Yakin was able to get away with that. But Stig is now the last man standing. He's going towards bombsite B. He's relatively undefended. He has to be careful, as he has one CT coming in from short. I don't think he knows, perhaps, checking every angle, but doesn't check that one. The only one where Seized is standing.
It's a good position from Seized, actually, if we go back there. Let's just quickly check out that position from Seized, because that's quite nice. We zoom through the black pass. Oh, here we go. Here we go. There we go. We found it. So, here he was. Right, was it here? No, was it here?
It was
here.
There, yep.
It was here,
yeah.
That's quite a nice position. It's one of those spots where you feel like you've checked it before you've really seen the spot. It's a nice one.
Again, the dry push into the bomb site. It's not going to work against Na'Vi, who are just on point with their shots. And I think they're just giving them fuel for some frag videos. Some frag movies where you get like Zeus just having an ace. Old school frag. And this is one thing I've noticed. You don't see a lot of those old school frag movies where you get like those eco pushes. I think it was more
the
of
pistols
the meta.
Are good now.
Yeah, pistols are good now, number one. It's true. And number two, you don't get these eco rushes anymore.
Or Skippy going for a fast peek with the AWP on mid. He's not going to get lucky here. They're looking to take some mid control, perhaps. Actually falling back there after that little peek. And they didn't see him, so they don't know exactly where Expert Gaming are at the moment. And the bomb is there in T-spawn. And Starix again, aggressive push on B-house from A-house, sorry, from Starix. And he gets the frag every time. He's been so good there.
Oh, very nice little boost there and a jump into window. As the Terrans get control of window, there are smokes all over the place. Guardian sees him run by, and I think he saw Guardian as well. Will Guardian be able to get that pick? This is a very, very acute angle. Oh, he takes down Spitty. Very nice there by Guardian. And he's going to push through. Missed the shot on Stig. Will he get the second? I have no idea. He's behind them. And that's some nice play by Guardian, because he completely shut down that push. That could have been very dangerous by Expert if they had been unchecked going in from window and connector. But Guardian gets himself the double. And that's 12-3 for NaVi. Expert Gaming starting off the second half a bit worse for wear than when they were against Lemon Dogs. And now they have to get, they have to string 12 rounds without NaVi stringing four. Seems relatively unlikely.
The only thing for them really is that they're not facing Delpan's orb. Guardian's not been as on form as Delpan was in the previous match. That's really the only nice thing for them.
But everyone else is on form.
Because Delpan was quite a big factor. But yeah, it does seem like their rifling overall is quite strong. And we're moving into the pistol round. We're seeing the standard strats from pistol again. Standard meta, 3-1-1 setup. Yakin in the very defensive spot. They get how this works. And let's see now how this actually goes. Because before, Expert had been just winning duels. They've been on top of the pistol fights. And are they going to be able to do it here? Because it will be an A push. And here it's going to come in. And they're going to have a late man for NaVi coming through connector to get the flank, because they are playing against this meta. They know that people will be rotating in through connector, so he's going to come out right behind them. So Expert got to be really on top of this. And look at that, Starx is going to make the kill from the flank. And now, oh, is he going to get, oh no, they're doing so well. It's a 3-on-3 though, and NaVi are decimate Ed with a 1-2 right at the end, and that's going to finish it off. NaVi to win the pistol, and Expert Gaming have got to be drenched right now. They're going to be perspiring like crazy.
Yeah, they must be really scared at the moment. The thing is, right, you know, you always have to keep that long-range advantage with the CT side. You can't let the Glock. And we've seen that so many times, even when in the last game, if the Ts get close to whoever's holding at CT spawn, they completely demolish them. The Glock is just so much better. But now we've got an interesting position here by Yakin with a shotgun. It looks like we might have a push into bombsite A, both from connector and from palace and T-ramp. Or is it going to be something else? You can see they're playing far too static. Terrorists are very, very confident. They're playing very aggressive T-play. They're moving in at the same time. I mean, it is an anti-eco, but last time we saw an anti-eco, it failed miserably. That was Expert Gaming just before, but Stig with two kills. Will he get the third? The bomb is down.
No bullets.
He's got no bullets left on his CZ.
Yeah.
There's only much you can do with that overpowered pistol. Thankfully, it's limited. It's got 24 bullets. It doesn't have any more than that. It would be a different story. But he didn't have a lot of HP left anyway, and they knew exactly where he was. There's not much he could do.
This was kind of the game I was expecting from NaVi, because they're just so much more. They were so much more structured, and they're much better on helping each other. And their rifle plays together are just much stronger. You can see the experience coming in from NaVi, and it's really paying off in dividends right now, as Expert Gaming kind of struggling to hold on. I mean, they had a bad T half, so we're not going to see their really expert CT half. Mm-hmm. That's really where they shine. But and that's the thing, it's top teams. You've got to be as balanced as possible on both sides. You can't just be good on one side. And that's really where Expert Gaming are going to have to go back and be like, how can we improve on our terrorist side?
That's something they have to improve, especially on Mirage. Their terrorist side is really lackluster. And they won't have a chance to play a really good CT half. They haven't been given the chance since they've lost the pistol round. They've lost the subsequent eco round. Now they're going to have to go for a false bite. It is a match point for NaVi. It could be a complete destruction of Expert Gaming right here by the Ukrainian side, who are looking a lot stronger than Lemon Dogs against the Norwegians. And it might be the last Norwegian hope being removed from the tournament. It's going to be a very, very sad day for the whole of Norway, as we get Expert Gaming not qualifying through Group D. On the other hand, NaVi rekindling hopes to continue in this tournament and giving them another chance to play against the loser of the Flipside versus Lemon Dog match. Expert here finally going for a full buy, or a full buy as they possibly can at the moment, against 5 AK-47s by NaVi. Interesting little play here as the terrorists getting control of mid, just pushing Sean at the same time. and the CTs are doing a good job staying nice and deep, and it's Guardian versus Spinny here in the room. Spinny will get the better of Guardian. Guardian perhaps being a bit too aggressive, not waiting for the support of his teammates. Seize will actually get the better of base. Nice job there by Skippy, actually takes down Seize. And Yakin will be holding his position hard. The terrorists are getting demolished here in bombsite A, and Expert Gaming are doing a job that round, making it a bit harder, making it take longer for NaVi to win. And we've just found out that Lemon Dogs beat Flipside 16-1. What is going on here on Group D?
More like it. I don't know. Maybe. No, I don't know.
What is going on?
Explanation for that.
NaVi destroying Expert at the moment. NaVi losing to Flipside. Flipside getting destroyed by Lemon Dog, who barely beat Expert. It doesn't make sense. I don't know. What sense can we make of it? But right now we're seeing the Expert CT side that we are used to watching against Lemon Dogs, and it could be a comeback. I mean, they have a lot of rounds to win. They need to win 11 in a row. They look solid.
A split coming up from House and Slope. And good position from base. Smoke carpeting everything. Oh, that's really nice there. Very good start. And that flank worked out wonderfully. They're down to three men there, really low. Even with some trades, even with a 3-on-3 situation, it's 3-on-3. Everyone is right there. They realize that the spot's very awkward. The smokes are dissipating, so they fell back. So another smoke coming in. They might retry this, actually, with a split on connector. That's actually really smart. But Stigwell, he's actually so smart as well. How did he know to just rush to that spot? Very, very good stuff. They still think that it could be a possible B, but the idea, of course, was another A split. They have a smoke to see from spawn. Oh, and Seize is going to get a frag. So it's looking good now for NaVi, but their health is low.
Indeed, so it's a 2-on-2 situation with Starix and Seize trying to retake the control of offside, but a double kill there by Stig. We'll let them survive another round. 15-5, and the score gets less embarrassing as we go on. NaVi are probably scratching their heads. Thought that, well, that's going to end really quickly. We could go home, have some dinner before we go to bed, ready for tomorrow's quarterfinals. But Expert are actually going to keep them up a little while longer, as we have a full eco here by the Ukrainian side. Skippy with an early kill there on mid. It's very standard play here by the CTs. They just have to make sure they don't make any huge mistakes. They don't give any guns to the T side. They do have CZs. CZs can be really, really brutal, as we experienced earlier on with the first anti-eco in the first half. But actually, at the moment, it just looks like Expert Gaming's aim has just become really, really on point. It really is on point. Once they pick up those M4s, they're just really, really good. Especially Yakin and Base, actually. Just getting those shots, like, it's no man's business. But 15-6, NaVi now with a full buy. Can Expert Gaming survive another round?
Yeah, they have no. They can't lose a round. The game's over then. The game is just over. And again, seeing the nice little pop flash there that I'm sure many people are going to start copying, because it is a nice one to get yourself in position there. But NaVi, they know that they can play around with their lead a lot. So they just want to just. I mean, and the thing is as well that they can lose so many rounds in a row being risky, because eventually the money loss bonus, the consecutive round loss bonus, will kick in very nicely for them. And they'll be able to buy. And they just have to win that one round. So this is really dangerous. And they're going to go for the execution here on this 8 bomb site.
That base will get the kill on Edward. He missed the first terrorist to push through. But that spray and pray, will actually work out for him. As Guardian gets a double kill, both on Yakin on Skippy. How did that happen? We don't know. It's 3-on-2 here as Guardian and Starix have control of the bombsite. Will Starix get the kill overall at short? No, he doesn't. Stig's got 20 HP. Starix pushing in CT spawn. Very confident play here by the Ukrainians as they take down Spitty. They have nothing to lose here. They've got so many rounds as a barrier. And now it's Stig and Base against Guardian. Will Guardian end the dreams? No, he won't. Base with a double kill here, taking down both Starix and Guardian. Will win the round for Expert Gaming, making it 15-7. And another round for the Norwegians. Is this the dream comeback? Is Expert Gaming the comeback team of the century? or are they going to lose sooner or later?
Well, it's okay for them because they are always going to be having the nades, as long as they don't sustain too many losses. This round, they can't afford to lose more than really two people because they can't really afford to do more than two drops the next round. That's really the case for them. They need to keep that economy in a good spot so they always can afford nades, because nades are just so important for the defensive side. Skippy does open up well with a frag onto Guardian there, but with a couple of men on the underground, Skippy's got to be on point, and expecting a play like that is, you get some sick angles from the underground onto the guy on mid. So let's see what they're up to here. They are actually even going to boost into that spot. So Skippy, let's have a look at him. He might be in some danger here. I don't know if he even realizes that there's a men boosting into his spot on the CPR. He's over in jungle right now, but things could get hairy momentarily here.
Yep. It's looking, the forecast is looking relatively well. On the Norwegian side, the bomb is down at 2 spawn. Edward actually getting a kill on Skippy, but he gives away his position. They know there's a terrorist there mid. They know there's a terrorist in connector. And it looks like the bomb will be going towards bomb site A here. And Starix will be going towards T-Ramp with the bomb in his backpack. Spitty. Firing all the way from short. Trying to see if he can get anybody here on connect. Doesn't take the damage, but not enough. Sees Wilt. And his crosshair in the right position against base. It's now 3-on-2. Yakin, Stig, and Spitty. Have to be very careful. They have to push at the same time or not push at all. Maybe far too many men, but Stig will rise to the occasion and take down Stig. Take down Starix, sorry. Both beginning with an ST. Very confusing. Seized. Yakin jumping on top of the box. We'll see over the smoke and get the kill. 15-8. NaVi, they have to win sooner or later.
So, lost quite a lot of men there. Just it's still okay though. But again, you know, they got to keep that money up.
Spitty's gonna have to get a gun from Yakin.
And so that was a pretty nice round. I was quite scared for them because the execution coming out from Seize was pretty strong, and they weren't taking the fight with the team super well. Oh, nice little peek there from base. But they just have to deal with an eco here. And this is one of those spots where again they can reinforce that economy, and they won't get a lot of these spots in the future because again, that consecutive money loss bonus is going to come into play, and NaVi are going to be doing buy upon buy upon buy, and that's where the economy, if too many losses are sustained for expert gaming, gets really bad. And they need to always be having full nades. I can't stress it enough. And they need to be having the setup that they play best with. Some teams, they practice a lot with, you know, multiple snipers, more expensive setups. Some teams are very comfortable with their setups on just rifles, and it really depends on the team. And expert gaming have been shown good because it's much less fragile than the more expensive setups in an economic standpoint. So now they're 15-9 against NaVi, and we're going to get this buy coming in. NaVi, we haven't really seen a crazy aggressive round from them on one of these buys yet, and I really think that it's going to be coming at some point soon. Let's see what they get up to. Oh, Skippy on point. Oh my god, popping off Starix's head.
Oh, yes, he's
up. Oh, and again!
Shot on Edward, not bad by Skippy.
It's a beheading.
Brutal. A lot of damage. How much is it? 400 and something?
Over there.
Which one of his wives was it?
I don't even know. But right now we're getting a 4v3, and they are making their way. They killed the player on connect, and we've seen that that's been pretty problematic for Expert in the past. So let's see how they react. They've got a very defensive line.
Oh my goodness, wow. Guardian is far too trigger happy as he takes down Zeus.
What is that?
What is he doing, Guardian? Guardian,
friendly
if a man
fire.
Is wearing a brown shirt, he is with you. If he is not wearing a brown shirt, he is against you. That's a good rule to follow. But now he puts it on a 2-on-4 situation. It might have been a different story, but Guardian perhaps trying to make things a bit more fair.
Let's watch him, see if he can make up for his past transgressions here.
Well, it's a 1-on-3, and Guardian is capable of doing the damage. He's going to get the bomb.
It's actually a pretty big deal as well if he dies and loses his AWP, because, you know, making those shots, like getting the loss of money there. Oh!
First kill on Skippy. He's got two more moles to shoot. Moles to hit. Fake bomb plant. They know it's a fake bomb plant. Looks around. Sees if he's going to get pushed. 14 seconds on the clock. He's going to have to plant it sooner or later. Puts it in the only position where they can't really peek him from. And the bomb gets planted. Now he's going to play whack-a-mole.
Very well played.
He's going to come from behind. Very well timed and well played. As they lured him with the juicy spitty.
So good. So many teams or players would have actually peaked earlier in that situation. But they had this setup, like one guy here.
I think it was a 50-50 situation.
And one guy here.
So but he could have been looking at the other angle.
If they both peek at the same time, they should always get the trade.
Unless
it's like a really weird angle, then they should always get the trade. So I really like that. That was very well played. Very smart stuff in the retake there. And that's why 2-on-1 should be so, so good if it's played, you know, perfectly. And
in
it should
right
usually
way.
Be played perfectly.
And not against an amazing player who can beat.
So 15-10, we're seeing the expert gaming magic again.
This is some crazy comeback here by the Norwegians again.
They are magical.
They love it. They love to create exciting CS for you guys. They love the viewers. That's why they lose the first 15 rounds and then they just go for that comeback from 15 to 3 to 15 to 10. 7 rounds in a row. Easy peasy, 11 squeezy here for the Norwegians. We're holding the same positions as usual. Actually, Base backing away a bit from Connector, giving them control of Connector. He's realizing that it's not really working out for him. Skippy missing that terrorist who pushed through shot, but he does give the information for the rest of his teammates so they don't get attacked from behind. We have two men here in bomb site B. Stig has been playing admirably through this tournament. He has really risen to the occasion. Will he be able to continue with the survival?
Here it comes. It's got to be coming soon here. The split is coming. It's coming. They know that it has to be coming soon. They spotted enough players. They figured it out, but they're still holding the lines. They aren't rotating quick enough. They've got to rotate, and Stig goes down without any response. Spitty's picking up the pieces, but just two. He needed to get more. It's a 3-on-3 here.
Well, Spitty made them pay for that push there. Double kill, could have made it 3, would have hurt even more, but now the CT side have to retake this bomb site. Are the dreams of expert gaming continuing on in this tournament going to be demolished by the Ukrainians this round, or are they going to do something quite intelligent and push into the bomb site at the same time? Now it's all up to Guardian to win their dreams. Wallbang is going to destroy him, and it's going to give expert gaming the 11th round. Very, very close there. Could have definitely gone Na'Vi's way.
Very good by City there to get that double. That really, really helped them out. And also, they were very quick to get... I mean, actually, in that spot, they didn't wait for base to come from short. They actually pushed into the site before he actually came. Because usually you want to get everyone pushing together.
But they just
actually went for it. And I actually liked that. I liked that they were on top of them before they could get position. And I think that was probably the thinking from them. We don't want to give them time to get in position.
Exactly.
So that allows it a situation where we can predict where they will be much better. They haven't been able to move much yet. So exactly. 15-11, the expert gaming, the Norwegian wonder team, pulling a marvelous result here in the second half. Still, I mean, they're playing for overtime. You just have to give it to them. These guys give such an amazing performance. So admirable for them to stick in
of course.
Game like this.
But if they kick out Na'Vi, that would be one of the biggest upsets really in this tournament so far. Na'Vi being kicked out by a BYOC qualifier. Here, Na'Vi might be making a mistake pushing into bombsite A, which is defended by three of the CTs, and Yakin is there as well. The master of bombsite A has done a very good job, but will be taken out by Edward. This is a good start here by Na'Vi, who pretty much almost have control of the bombsite. They smoke out the vast majority of the CT players. Stig is still in bombsite B, thinking that the terrorists are going to come.
Oh my god,
I don't know what
he's
doing. All of the T's are in bombsite A, and it doesn't look very probable that the CT side are going to come back from this. They're going to hide. They're not going to do any peek. Skippy here giving away his position. Stig, it's 1-on-3, and there you go. Expert gaming out. Na'Vi through to the final of this group, where they will be playing against Lemon Dogs.
Norwegian
Sorry,
dream
they're
is
playing
over.
Against Flipside. Yeah, the Norwegian dream is over. It's going to be Flipside against Na'Vi, the rematch that I'm sure a lot of you have been waiting for, especially the Na'Vi fans.
Man, if they just tidied up that T side, they would be so scary. That T side for them has just, in both matches, has just been their downside. Just two more rounds on the terrorist side, and they would be golden. And it's not
exactly.
They got like 3 rounds each time. It's just crazy.
Exactly.
What they're demanding is like, oh well, guys, we're probably gonna lose everything on T, but it's all right. We're so good at CT. We'll just win 15 in a row. It's fine.
I mean, it's really tough for Expert Gaming, who played very well, very close game against Lemon Dogs, and relatively close game against Na'Vi. As you said, they played just a bit of a better T side. But there you go, Expert Gaming out. Na'Vi having a second chance against Flipside.
That
will
be
played in a moment. You can see that in the main channel. But it's that's pretty much all from us. Thank you very much for tuning in with us today. And B being with us as we had casted the prior two games before. There have been some very scintillating games today as well, even in Group C. Well, not as scintillating as Group D, but we've seen some pretty good CS indeed. And it was an absolute pleasure for me to be casting with DDK today for you. We're going to tell you guys a bit about FaceIt. FaceIt, the platform that you guys can go and play CSGO on. You guys can play in tournaments, win points, and even win yourself some prizes. There are some nice leagues that you'll be placed in, so you'll be playing around the same level as you are, hopefully. Silver, Gold, and Master. And it's definitely a platform to check out. 128 tick rate servers. Loads of cool guys to play with.
There's
cool
more
admins.
It's more of a community going on because
it's true though.
If you look at matchmaking, it's such a huge amount of players going on there. I mean, with FaceIt, you segregate things into the different. Yeah. If you play your placement matches, you get segregated into skill groups which are closer to your skill, and you get to play with some of the same people. There's loads of games going on and tournaments as well, so you'll see quite a lot of the same people and. The games will be harder, a bit harder in general as well, but you get much better playing conditions as well and people that actually try harder too. Yeah. So you get a really, it's a much different experience than Valve matchmaking.
You're
so
right,
it's definitely something to test out.
It's well moderated as well. That's one thing as well. I mean, any of the people who cause problems who are caught doing anything dodgy, they get banned and they get punished. So it's very, very clean environment to play in. And if you see somebody who does something, you can always tell an admin straight away. And with the good proof, and that you can get them in trouble. So it's a really nice, clean environment to play some CS and to improve. And as we mentioned earlier on, there have been teams that have actually been picked up from FaceIt. Fnatic is one of those. So it's definitely something to check out. And you can also check out the Twitter of Danir at @followDDK, and you can check out mine at @DRAvela if for some reason you're interested in sending me a tweet or two. And to be honest, I haven't actually got a lot of tweets from you guys. Not enough, honestly.
Oh,
not
so
enough.
So
really,
sad.
I'm a
he's
bit
so
sad.
Sad right
I've
now.
Been telling, as I was drinking my high fructose corn syrup, aloe juice or aloe vera, I was telling him, I'm not getting that many. I'm not that popular. I don't feel like a caster. There's not enough support coming from the community. So look at my puppy dog eyes and check us out. And also, you can check out FaceIt at FaceIt on Twitter or www.faceit.com to take a look at. Tomorrow, we'll be doing the quarterfinals. Me and Dan will be here. One last final time for DreamHack Winter, so be with us same time. DreamHack.
I know in the UK it does feel like winter.
I'm sweating and dying here. Why would I think winter? I don't know. Winter is coming.
Sounds cooler. I don't know.
Yeah, winter is coming. That's why I said I was thinking of Game of Thrones. New episode of Game of Thrones.
Mm. Oh, God.
Something to watch
God
tonight.
Damn it. All right, guys. Well, I think that's everything from me and Avela. We'll see you tomorrow for a quarterfinal match. So you got to be up bright and early for that, but it will be worth it, and we'll see you then.
Take care.